blind from his birth. They just say he was blind. Number two, he looks at him. He sees, the Bible says, he sees me. How do you know what a man looks like when he's been blind? Amen. Number two, or number three, rather, the Bible says, and he they look like walking trees. And now you've never seen a tree before, you've been blind. So it really suggests, at least, that this man had some interaction with sight prior to. Amen. And I'm going to show you something else in just a moment. Watch what he says. The Bible says that he looked up, verse 24, and he said, I see men as trees walking. Verse 25 says, and after that, he put his hands again upon his eyes. Now watch this. Jesus does what men expect first, because spit ends with this one, right? He spits in the man's eyes and touches him. He asked him, he said, now you will see. But I want you to pay close attention to verse 25. Because this time the Bible says Jesus puts his hand on the man's eyes and he touches him again. But here's the thing that's really interesting to me in this chapter. He says, and he made him live. You missed it. Look at your Bible now. Look at your Bible. Look at your iPhone. Look down the candy crush for 2 seconds. And come here to play games. Why don't you to listen? The Bible says, and he made him look up. Is that in the text? Yeah. See, sometimes we want to do things our way. Praise the Lord. And then here's the beautiful thing about it. Look at what he says. He says, after he made him look up, the Bible says, and he was restored. Woo. He was restored. Apokathistin. The Lord brought him back to the place that he was previously. That's what that word literally means. The Lord gave him the sight that he once had before. And so what happens here? Then the Bible goes on to say, not only that, and he saw. He saw every man clearly. That word literally means he saw from afar. So not only has his sight been restored to what he used to have, now he can look and see everybody clearly afar off. Which suggests that they took him out of town. He says, now look around him. Do you see everybody? He said, I see everybody. He said, what about the man down the street? I see him too. See everybody clearly. He was physically blind, but Jesus made him physically see. And for somebody today, somebody might be spiritually blinded today. But God said, I can let you see. Amen. I can bring sight to you this morning. All you got to do is a few things. All you got to do is obey the gospel. You may not even understand it fully. You may not understand, why do I have to go down front? Why do I have to confess Jesus? You know, it reminds me of the Old Testament. There was a man by the name of Naaman. He was a great leader. He was a Gentile. But the Bible says he knew there was a prophet in Israel. The prophet by the name of Elijah. He says, Master, his servant says, Master, why don't you go see this prophet? I heard he's a great man, but he has the power of God. He says, okay, let's go on and go. Let's grab a couple of horses and go down there and see Elijah. But the interesting thing was, when he got to see Elijah, the Bible suggests to us that Elijah may have been too busy to talk to him. Elijah sent his servant out and said, this is what you need to do. You need to dip 7 times. Dip 7 times. But not just dip 7 times, I need you to dip 7 times in a particular river. And when you dip 7 times in a particular river, what you'll find is that your skin will be restored back to its normal elasticity. You don't have the white bumps. You don't have all these other things on your body. Once you do what I tell you to do, Naaman became inferior. Naaman says, do you not know who I am? No, I'm a big in this city. Everybody knows my name. You send a servant to talk to me? You don't know who I am. You know, that's how we think sometimes. But then, his servant, he said,
Church of Christ. I want y'all to be patient with me.
time because I feel in my spirit somebody wants to obey the gospel.
Amen.
All right.
Somebody needs to obey the gospel. Life is too short. Young people leave back like old people. And once you die, there's no redeeming. There's no melody, as they say, in God. You don't have another chance to get away. This is the only chance. God gave you today. He gave you today. They call it a present because it's a gift. But don't reject it. Jesus died on the cross for you. We sing that, and we celebrate his memorialize his death every Sunday. But if you don't obey the gospel, his death means nothing to you. It means that you are treading underfoot the blood of Jesus Christ. Every time you walk out of your understanding, you tell Jesus, I don't care what you did. You say that enough times, and the Lord will knock on your door. He says, I gave you Sunday before last. I gave you a month of Sundays. I gave you years of Sundays. And you rejected me every time. You had a new excuse every Sunday. And that preacher stood there and tried to beseech you to come, begged you to come. All you did was sing the song and sat back down and came back the next Sunday and do the same thing. But the Lord says, will you come? Will you come? Brothers and sisters, I've said it right. You want to be a member of God's church, obey the gospel. If you need prayer, stand right where you are as we stand and sing the song of invitation. Why don't you come with me?